With hundreds of millions of dollars in sales every year, the poinsettia is still the undisputed most popular Christmas plant. But what exactly is a poinsettia and how do you take care of one? That's what we're here to find out. Now, the poinsettia actually grows wild in Mexico, and its name comes from Joel Roberts Poinsett, who was the first U.S. ambassador to Mexico. And he's widely credited as being the first person to sort of introduce the poinsettia into general popularity in the United States. The poinsettia's connection with Christmas is thought to originate from a 16th century Mexican legend in which a young girl who was too poor to afford a Christmas gift placed some weeds in front of a church altar and they bloomed into beautiful red poinsettia flowers. If you do travel to the mountains of Mexico where this plant grows wild, you'll find it growing in dry forests as a shrub. And in order to get this nice, compact, well-branched form that we have in the greenhouse here, the plants go through quite a rigorous cultivation program where they're handled many times. It's considered one of the most labor-intensive crops. So things from pinching, fluffing to keep them looking nice, keeping them in rings, all of these things go into producing these beautiful, compact plants. Now, they're not only available in red, they're also available in white, various shades of pink, burgundy, marbled forms, so there's kind of something for everyone with poinsettias. But let's talk a little bit about how to actually care for poinsettias. The first thing I'd like to talk about is actually getting them home safely. With any plant, and poinsettias are no exception, when you're transporting plants to your home in the winter, always make sure that your vehicle is warmed up first and foremost. And then try not to stop anywhere on your way home. If you are going to make some stops, make them brief, keep the vehicle running so it stays nice and warm. Also make sure that wherever you're buying the plants from, that they're wrapping them for you, preferably in paper. If they have to be in plastic, that's better than nothing, but paper is definitely preferred. Once you get your poinsettia home, make sure that you place it in a brightly lit location, preferably near a bright window. If you're displaying them for a short period of time, having them in a darker area is not that big of a deal. But if you're going to be displaying them for several weeks or longer, having them in a brightly lit area is important because if the light isn't strong enough, you will start to notice a lot of leaf drop and that sort of thing. The most important thing in poinsettia care is definitely watering. So if you are buying these guys in speed covers, which is the usual case where they have those nice colored foil wrappers around the pots, very important that you are not allowing water to sit in the bottom of that speed cover. The easiest way to kill a poinsettia is to overwater it or having it sitting in water. So either bring the plant to the sink and water it so that the water drains out of the pot before you replace the speed cover. Or if you leave the pot in the speed cover, just make sure that you remove it, dump the water out, and then replace the pot in the speed cover. As far as how often to water, when to water, two good tricks. One is you can actually look at the color of the soil in the pot. It will turn a light brown color, and the pot will feel quite light when it's time to water. So you do want the soil to almost completely dry out between watering, but not totally. They don't want to stay, you know, dry to the point that they wilt, but definitely avoid waterlogged soils with these guys. As far as fertilizer, not necessary during the blooming period. If you do decide that you want to keep your poinsettia after Christmas, I'll give you a few tips on that as well. You'll want to definitely place the plant in a brightly lit window, so like an east or west window, even a south-facing window is fine during the winter. Continue watering it as normal. You can start fertilizing around the middle of February with a triple 20 fertilizer. Start about once a month. By the end of April, beginning of May, you can be fertilizing with that triple 20 every 2 weeks. And what you'll want to do is after the flowers have actually faded, you will want to cut the plant back by about half and then let it sort of regrow. And you can prune it throughout the course of the summer as it grows to give it a nice compact shape as well and keep it well branched. Do not prune after the beginning of September. Now, a really important thing to get these guys to actually color up is starting in the beginning of October, they need to have shorter days. So when you're growing in the home, that means you want to either have the plant in a spare room that you're not using, or move the plant into a closet when it gets dark outside. The plants need to have at least 12 hours of darkness per day in order to get them to color up properly. When you're looking for a poinsettia to purchase in the store, a couple tips on that as well. Try not to buy a poinsettia that's in a plastic sleeve, and the reason for that is you can't really see the full shape of the plant. So then when you get it home, take that sleeve off, the plant may not be as attractive as it looked in the sleeve. So try to buy them out of the sleeve like this so you can see exactly what the shape of the plant is like. Definitely make sure in the home or wherever you're keeping the plants that they are away from drafts and heat registers as well, because both of those things will decrease the longevity of the flowers. So that about wraps it up for this video on poinsettias. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also check out our holiday video playlist here at Greenland Garden Center. We've got lots of tips for decorating your home for the holidays. And right after this video, check out our holiday plants video where you can see all of the other Christmas plants you can bring into your home to deck the halls besides just poinsettias. I'm Joe Gadbois with Greenland Garden Center. Thanks for watching.